Hey everybody, welcome to our brand new format, Beyond Armour. My name is Nico and I'm the Technical Sales Manager of Mehler Protection Body Armour. Today we'll talk about the use of the helmets in military or police operations. The helmets normally protect from bullets of handguns, shrapnels, blunt blows, falls and impacts. Regardless of the category of the helmet, ballistic helmets are made of either polyethylene or aramide or titanium or a mix of all of that. So the choice of material used depends on the particular protection requirements the helmet is intended to fulfill. So how is a ballistic helmet made? Polyethylene or aramide are stacked in several layers and cut into shape. The cuts are then pressed into a mold and heated in stages. Titanium can also be integrated for durability and stiffness of the inner shell. This is followed by coloring and adjusting of the final helmet, and in the final steps, the inside fittings, rails and shrouds are added. Helmets made of polyethylene and aramide fibers offer a higher level, low weight protection against fragments, ricochets and explosions. So this type of helmet is particularly suitable for military personnel exposed to threats of a modern battlefield and in need of a lightweight helmet that can be worn for a stretch of time lasting several hours or a whole day. Helmets made out of a combination of titanium with aramide or polyethylene deform only slightly when they're struck by a bullet and are bulletproof even along the periphery. Therefore, they offer a large surface of effective protective against bullets even in the outlining. Mehler Protection offers different types of helmet depending on the potential threat. The Omega Core was especially designed for military applications. It offers a high fragment protection as well as protection against projectiles from handguns. Made out of high-performance polyethylene, it provides an excellent lightweight ballistic protection. Due to its inner design, the helmet offers an outstanding performance in comfort and air ventilation. Due to its channels we integrated in the front and the netting inside, you have a permanent airflow over your head, and this exceeds the time you can wear the helmet in the combat zone. The Omega Hybrid helmet was designed for law enforcement and special operations. Offering heavier but a more extensive protection, it was designed for robust protection. Coupled with it, superb comfort and exceptional versatility, the combination of minimal weight, extraordinary ballistic protection and low residual energy is made possible by its innovative high-performance polyethylene outer shell and supremely strong titanium inner shell. One point about the helmets are the helmet cuts or helmet shapes. So the difference between low, mid and high cut helmets are vital. Each style of helmet has its own advantages and disadvantages and is designed to meet different operational needs. From tactical mobility to comprehensive protection, it's important to know that the helmet shapes and the area of coverage are not standardized. So the coverage can widely change with the helmet. High cut helmets like these two providing reliable protection against bullets, shrapnel and other threats. The target groups are special forces and tactical units. Its lightweight, streamlined design combined with the possibility of attaching active hearing protection as well as the better ventilation and airflow, which reduces heat buildup during long missions, making them an excellent choice for operations requiring agility and situational awareness. Of course, the advantages come with the sacrifice of protection for the sides and back of the head, making them less suitable for high-risk combat scenarios that demand maximum coverage. A low-cut helmet is also known as a full-cut helmet. It offers a higher level of protection against impacts, projectiles and shrapnel, covering the ears, sides and back of the head. Low-cut helmets are commonly used by military personnel and law enforcement officers who require maximum protection in high-risk situations. Its heavier and bulkier design can restrict mobility and cause discomfort during extended wear. The full coverage makes it difficult to fit certain tactical helmet headsets or communication devices. The mid-cut helmet is a good balance between coverage and comfort. Widely used by law enforcement officers and military personnel in certain operational scenarios, the helmet covers the ears and the most of the head. So it offers a good level of protection without the bulkiness of a low-cut helmet. They are certainly an option to consider for those who require a mix of protection and practicality in their tactical gear.